but you don't tell no one. You can tell me, little ghost of tan like milk and honey. You're very
Hello everybody, my name is Sarah, and today I'm going to be talking to you about how I moved to California and how you can move to California too, and how basically you can travel the world for little to no money or on minimum wage or no income at all. I have five different ways of how you can move to California, from least expensive to most expensive, so yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, so my first way is going to be WOOF. If you've never heard of WOOF, basically what it stands for is Worldwide Opportunities on Organic Farms, and it's $40 a year, and with that $40 you get a database of thousands of farms in the United States that need help, labor on their farm, and are willing to provide you a place to live. WOOF is really good if you wanted to experience a new place of the world for not a lot of money. It is completely free to live on the farm in exchange for however many hours a week that the farmer or the owner of the farm wants you to work. Some farms are 15, some farms are 25 hours a week. You just have to find the farm that's right for you. With that $40, you get their contact information and their full profile, which has basically all the information about the farm, such as the accommodations that they're going to be giving you. Are you going to be living in a tent? Are you going to be living in a private bedroom, etc.? And what they're going to ask you to do, how many hours a week they're going to ask you to do it, what their farm is about, how many people are going to be on the farm, and how long they like people to come and stay. Woofing is a great way to experience maybe an island in Hawaii, or if you want to work in Greece, Italy, anywhere in Europe pretty much. But the downside is you have to purchase the membership for each country that you want to go, so you should be pretty positive about which country you want to woof in. Some farms will provide you food as well. You just have to go through all the farms that interest you and find the best one for you. While it is free to woof, other than exchanging your labor, it would only be good for a short period of time due to the fact that income you need to buy food and other things and supplies to basically live. So I would go into it having a lot of money with an open mind in order to exchange your time and work for living in a beautiful place. All right, and my second way that you can move to California is through Workaway. So Workaway is similar to WOOF, but instead of farming, you might be doing something else like housework, cooking, cleaning, watching somebody's dog. I don't know. There's a million different jobs that you could do that people are looking for people to come in and help them in exchange for a place to live and possibly some food. I also forgot to mention that with Workaway, you can also do like international trades, like teaching English or volunteering at a school or basically building houses in another country. I think that that's what it's most popular for, but you can also do things within the United States. So my third way that you can move to California for little to no money is through coolworks.com. I personally love Coolworks, and I have spent hours and hours just scrolling through all their jobs. They organize their website by national parks, states, or category, and I think there's a few others, but it's super great because you can just search all of the resort jobs, tour companies, etc., and you don't need to have a lot of skills to do so. All right, so just real quick, look at the Coolworks website. I like to search by state, so we will just click on a random state here. Let's do California, and it'll show you all of the different jobs that are available in California right now, and there's just so many cool ones. I've spent hours on here just looking at all the different opportunities, so let's just click on a random one, and I'll show you basically what a job's profile will look like. Real quick, I forgot to mention that with Coolworks, most of the companies will offer housing, have it included with the job, or like offer it for a little bit of money, like each week from your paycheck. Coolworks is so awesome because basically it's a database of jobs in cool places, and I honestly could not agree more. Using Coolworks is how I got my job here in Yosemite National Park, and it's also how I got hired in Alaska for the summer. So log on to Coolworks and select any random job, and you'll be able to see that job's profile, which means it'll show you if they're going to provide housing and how much it costs. Is it going to be included if they don't provide housing? If they provide any discounts on food, whether or not there's cell service in the area, whether or not you're going to have Wi-Fi. So it's super cool because you can see everything about the job before you even go and what the life is going to be like, the employee experience, the things they offer for employees on like your time off, things to do in the area on your time off, and more. I am also part of a Facebook group called Parkies. And basically it's a group of like a couple thousand people that work and travel seasonally and that are looking for jobs in national parks or at different resorts around the country. It's really cool because you can talk to everyone who maybe has experienced a job that you're interested in and get some feedback on the management, on the living situation, and more. All right, and so now for my fourth way that you can move to California for little to no money. This one's going to be on a little bit of the pricier side, but renting just a room from somebody is a great way to not have to pay a lot of utilities for an entire space. Apartments in California are so expensive, so if you find a nice area maybe outside of a city that you want to live in, you could find a room for about $500, $600, $700 per month. I know that probably seems like a lot, but in reality, after living here for over a year, that is not very much money. So I would say check out Facebook Marketplace, because that's where I've been spending hours and hours. After I visited San Francisco, I just loved it so much, and I was like, I'm moving here. It didn't end up working out, but I'm really glad because I really love it here in Yosemite and I have some great plans for the summer. I would definitely avoid Craigslist at all costs. Craigslist is so sketchy. The people here will try and scam you, and you don't need that. Don't use Craigslist. My fifth and final way that you can move to California is through communal living. So whatever city or state you want to live in, start by researching the shared rooms or private rooms for rent. But then also, if you're interested in maybe living with a community of people that all put forth something to the greater good of the group, you should definitely check out communal living. For one example that I have is Upstart Creative in LA. I have never used it myself, but I did send in an application and get approved. It was kind of one of those spur of the moments, I'm just gonna get up and move to LA. Never happened, but it was fun to kind of imagine. But Upstart Creative, basically it is a community of a bunch of artists, photographers, models, musicians, etc. And they all live in a mansion in LA. And I think it goes approximately 750 plus. I think maybe there's some that are like in the 600. For a pod, bear with me, I know, why would anyone want to live in a pod? Personally, I don't care about extreme living situations like living in a tent, living in a pod, sharing a room with like 10 people. I don't care, I'm just here to experience the area. So if you are interested, I will leave a link down below to Upstart Creative and you can put in an application and see if it's a good fit for you. Okay, so I lied, I said I had 5 ways that you could move to California, but I actually have 6. So here's the 6th one. Airbnb. You'd be surprised how cheap Airbnb could be if you rent by the month. Sometimes the renters will give you a discount, and I've found some in Santorini, Greece for like $500 a month, and it blew my mind. I was like, yes, I'm gonna go stay in Santorini for a month alone in a cute little white house on a cliff. Of course I am. All right, so that is all I have for the five methods that you can use to move to California or move to anywhere in the world. These really do apply anywhere for the most part. But I'm also going to talk about getting to where you want to be and then getting around if you don't have a car. Having a car is great. I've loved having a car. However, it becomes so expensive. I was on my own insurance and it was almost $300 a month just for insurance alone and then gas, which is probably about $4 or more in California, depending on where you live. But overall, it just really, really adds up. Registration fees every single year. So I sold my car and I'm kind of glad that I did because now I am free to go anywhere I want in the world and I don't have to be weighed down by it. So I'm going to talk about some other ways if you don't have a car, that's okay. I'm going to talk about public transportation in big and small cities and other ways of getting around. Personally, I've used the YARTS bus. YARTS bus stands for, I believe, Yosemite Area Regional Transportation System. I don't know, I'm sorry. But basically it'll take you in and out of the park and then you can actually take a YARTS bus to the train. And then from the train, you can travel all around the state. So the train is the Amtrak train. And the Amtrak train will take you to big and small cities anywhere around the state. And it's a little bit on the pricier side, but honestly, I have a feeling that it'll be much, much cheaper than having a car. So having a car is not necessary at all, but it definitely is helpful depending on your plan. If you don't plan to travel across the ocean for a long period of time or go to a different country, then get a car and keep it and travel around the United States. Personally, I had to sell it because I'm going to Hawaii and then Alaska and then Europe. So as you can imagine, I can't take my car with me. I'm very sad. I miss her very much, but it's what needed to happen. If you don't have a car and are going to be traveling a very long distance to get to your job that you got or your work trade or whatever, I would definitely recommend using Google Flights to get cheap flights. Google Flights takes all of the airlines and filters them by date and when they're going to be the cheapest. I only use Google Flights. I do not use anything else because typically I can find the best prices there. Don't use Expedia. It's not worth it. All the prices are always so much higher. Just use Google Flights. And I've heard a couple people mention Skyscanner. I've never personally used it because I'm so set in my ways and I only use Google Flights, but that's definitely something to consider. All right, so I'm just going to show you how Google Flights works. So select an origin. For example, I'm going to do San Francisco, select one way, and then any destination in the world. I am going to be choosing Maui, Hawaii, just because I am traveling to Hawaii soon. So for example, we'll just use Maui, and then you're going to click on the calendar up where it says Sunday, February 9th, and see which dates are the cheapest to fly. Alright, so if you just select any random one, it'll show you all of the airlines that are flying that route that day and their prices. Alright, and to wrap up the video, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about me and my story. I am from upstate New York, and I lived there for about 18 years, and I was just not happy in Rochester. And when I was 18, I decided I was going to move to California and packed up my Ford Focus and drove across the country. I was never super passionate about just one thing enough to want to go to college or turn anything into a career. I knew that I wanted to travel and create things. I really like to draw and take pictures and make videos. So I didn't want to put myself in a position to be in debt for the rest of my life and where I probably wouldn't have ended up being very happy if I went to college and staying in New York. So I'm incredibly grateful that I made the decision to come to California because it has absolutely changed my life. It is so amazing here. You just need to come check it out for yourself. So if you're eager to see the world on a budget, you could definitely try these five different ways to see the world for little to no money. Some things to keep in mind is that you should be okay being alone pretty much all of the time. I had to learn how to appreciate my own company. I used to be very upset that I was alone all the time, that I didn't really have a lot of people to surround myself with. And then I started going in beautiful places like this forest I'm sitting in right now, and everything was okay. Now I appreciate the silence. I appreciate being alone and away from people as much as I can, which is a huge growth step for me. You should be good at saving money, especially if you're gonna go woof or do work away or any kind of work trade, because you might not be getting paid. And it's kind of all about experiencing the place that you're doing it in and having enough money in the meantime to afford to eat. You should also be okay with adapting to strange living conditions, like living in a tent with two other people, living in a pod, sharing a room with one or many people, or living in a space with one or many people, sharing bathrooms, sharing common areas, sharing kitchens, things like that. Those are the little sacrifices that I make on a daily basis to be able to travel and live in such beautiful places. All right, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are going to be using any of my 6 ways to travel the world for little to no money, then let me know and share your story. I would love to hear from you. Comment down below, follow my Instagram, and like and subscribe. Thank you. Bye.